Good day, everyone. Welcome again to another episode of Basic Transfer Pricing. Today, we will discuss to you how to fill up the new BIR Form 1709 under RR 34-2020, dated December 21, 2020. So, ito yung superseding the RR 19-2020. Okay? So, this BIR Form number 1709 was enhanced on December 2020, at ito po ang information return on transactions with related party, foreign and or domestic. No? So, paano po natin ito ipi-fill up? Enter all required information in capital letters using black ink. Mark applicable boxes with an X. Two copies must be filed with the BIR and one held by the tax filer. No? So, line number one for the calendar or fiscal year. So, sino itong calendar year? Ito yung ending December 31, ang taxable year. At yung fiscal year naman, ito yung ending niya is other than December. No? Line number 2 is the year ended. So, lagay po natin yan kung anong month at saka anong year. No? Number of sheets attached. And then we have the part 1 or the background information. Line number 4 is for the taxpayer identification number. Number 5 is for the RDO code, no? Yung magkamali dito sa RDO code. Pag nag-fill up kayo ng BIR form number 1709, see to it na dala-dala nyo yung inyong certificate of registration. So, we have the taxpayer's name. So, last name, first name, middle name for individual or registered name for non-individual, no? So, remember na yung may registered name dito, non-individual. Pagka naman taxpayer's name, ito yung pangalan na nasa birth certificate ng tao, hindi yung nasa DTI na business name, ha? Line number 7 is the registered address, no? So, very specific na po yung address natin ngayon. Meron siyang specific talaga na address kung saan po situated yung ating business. Nakalagay po dito, indicate complete address. If branch, indicate the branch address. If the registered address is different from the current address, go to the RDO to update registered address by using BIR form number 1905. Ibig sabihin, kung lumipat kayo sa dating address nyo, dapat nag-update kayo sa BIR kung saan po kayo dati naka-registered. No? So, in the event na hindi pa kayo naka-transfer, file these returns on the RDO where you are registered. No? Okay. So, line number 7A is your zip code. Line number 8 is your contact number, landline or cell phone number, and line number 9, email address. Take note, ha, dahil po ito yung bago because of the COVID, because of the pandemic, and because of the new normal that we have, our email address is very important. That's why kung mapapansin natin, lahat ng corporations were required by the SEC to submit their email address. Why? Because under the rules of procedure din ng court na sa electronic evidence, ang email address na pagka pinadala ka ng notice doon sa email address mo, that is tantamount already of proper delivery of notices. So, hindi na natin masabi na sa email lang yan, kailan pa hard copy. Hindi na po kailan ng hard copy, basta official na yung email address mo na pinaregister mo sa SEC. So, ganun din po sa BIR. Kaya dito nakalagay yung email address nyo because notification using this email address is already tantamount as the same with that of the hard copy na pinapadala po sa courier o kaya sa post office. No? Part 2, details of related parties. No? Fill out the table properly with not applicable, if not applicable, and use additional sheets if necessary. So, letter A, ito na po ha, foreign related parties. Sino ba yung mga foreign related parties mo na kung halimbawa ikaw ay subsidiary dito sa Pilipinas? Yung column number 1 is the name, and then next is the nature of relationship, kung subsidiary ka ba or branch or permanent establishment, and then the country of residence. Country of residence po ito ng foreign related parties. And then we have the foreign tax identification number and the local tax identification number. No? Kasi sa susunod meron na pong global tax identification number. Kasi isa na lang tayo, no? Then meron ng global tax. With permanent establishment in the Philippines, yes or no? And then the TIN of PE or tax identification number of the permanent establishment. Letter B is the domestic related parties, name, nature of relationship, the TIN, and then the registered address of the domestic related parties. Part 3, related party transactions. Letter A, sale of goods and provisions of services. So, ano itong sale of goods and provision of services? This is your income. No? Ito yung functions mo, dito ka kumikita, dito ka nag-ooperate. No? So, name of related party, description and type of transactions, amount in foreign currency, if applicable, amount in peso. Were you granted treaty benefit in the source country? Yes or no? Also very important, yung treaty benefits. No? So, income tax withheld by the income or payer. No? Karamihan, they escape withholding tax. Ngayon, this sa related parties, makita mo na kasi so many people na encounter ko na they deny na hindi daw sila subject sa withholding tax. No? So, ngayon, makikita na talaga dito. Kasi once you have the income, designated po na withholding agent, especially if you have creditable withholding tax at source. Pag ikaw yung may hawak, ikaw yung buyer, bago mo yan ibayad, talaga mag-withhold ka. So, makikita yan dito. Especially, designated na withholding agents na ngayon yung mandatory na top 20,000 taxpayers and also the large taxpayers. No? Letter B, purchase of goods and services except those provided by KA management personnel or the KMP. Because under RR 34-2020, yung KA management personnel, hindi na po kailangan na kasama siyang i-report. No? So, for column number 1, we have the name of related party, description and type of transactions. We have the amount in foreign currency if applicable. We have the amount in peso. And then, did the income recipient claim treaty benefits? Yes or no? Was a TTRA filed for? Yes or no? Ito ano itong TTRA? Ito yung tax treaty relief application. At saan po ito ina-apply? Doon po sa International Tax Affairs Division po ng BIR. Nasa Agham Road po dito sa Quezon City. Income tax withheld by the income or payer, if any. Is the income payment attributable to PE? Yes or no? Ito yung permanent establishment. Then we have page 2 of this BIR Form 1709. We have the continuation of part 3. No? Letter C, loans granted to or non-trade receivable from related parties. We have name of related party, opening balance. No? Ito yung receivable, no? From related parties. Loans granted during the taxable period. We have terms and conditions. Ano yung terms and conditions? May interest ba yan? O 30 days lang ba yan? O 90 days? Outstanding balance as of the end of the taxable period. And then take note, mayroong provisions for doubtful debts. Kung ito ba related party, hindi lang babayad. No? Budget expense recognized during the period. Ano tong budget expense recognized during the period? Ito yung charge na natin as an expense. No? Hindi lang na nag-provide lang tayo ng provision. Letter D, loans received from non-trade payable to related party. Ano naman to non-trade payable? This can be another payable, pero hindi siya related sa trade. So, name of related party, opening balance, loans received during the taxable year, terms and conditions, and then the outstanding balances of the end of the taxable year. Letter E, other related party transactions excluding compensation paid to KA management personnel. Ito yung wala doon sa 19-2020. No? So, dividends and branch profit remittances, so hindi na ito kasama, excluding sila na i-disclose. No? Dito sa 1709, ito yung K management personnel na compensation, tapos yung dividends, at saka yung branch profit remittances. No? So, we have name of related party, description and type of transactions, amount of foreign currency, no? If applicable, and then the amount in peso. Kasi remit, ano to eh, transactions ito, no? So, kung ang katransaction mo dito is situated outside of the country, then you can also use a different currency aside from peso. Part 4 is the additional disclosure. Letter A, disclosure ito ha, is a type, parang explanation. Letter A, brief business overview of the ultimate and immediate parents of the taxpayer. No? If you have the documentation, then no worry because you can fill this up easily kasi meron ka ng source document. Letter B, brief business overview, functional profile of the taxpayer. Itong mga sinasabi dito na information, saan ito manggagaling? We have the OECD 2017 Transfer Pricing Guidelines, which discloses to us the three-third documentation requirements. And what are those? We have the master file, the local file, and also the country-by-country reporting. So, if you have those documents with you, wala kayo problema. Why? Kasi kukopyahin nyo na lang yun and then fill this up in this part for additional disclosure. So, letter C, we have here, has there been any change in your functional profile during the taxable period? If yes, provide details. No? Yes or no? Has there been any change in your ownership structure during the taxable year? If yes, provide details. Yes or no? So, ano tong ownership structure? Can be in the form of business restructuring. Letter E, did you undergo business restructuring during the taxable period or for the last 5 years? No? Itong business restructuring dito can be maraming form ito, hindi lang ownership structure, no? So, if yes, provide details. And then we have page 3, continuation of part 4, no? Letter F, have you prepared, ito na po, a transfer pricing documentation for the related party transactions as prescribed under Revenue Regulations number 2-2013. Yun po yung transfer pricing analysis, no? So, the details of the TPD include but not limited to the following: organizational structure, nature of the business or industry and market conditions, controlled transactions, assumptions, strategies and policies, cost contribution arrangement, comparability, functional and risk analysis, selection of the transfer pricing method, application of the transfer pricing method, background documents and index to documents. No? So, ito yung mga tinatanong niya dito. So, yes or no lang. So, siguro, pag may kulang, dun ka na sa no. No? Kailangan pag nag-yes ka, kompleto. Letter G, do you have pending applications for relief with the BIR, with the authority of other countries? No? So, ano itong pending applications for relief? Ito yung tax treaty relief. No? If yes, provide details. Kasi, as of now, the Philippines has tax treaties with 43 different countries. Letter H, do you have an advance pricing arrangement, agreement with your related parties, yes or no? Itong advance pricing agreement, pinafile din po ito sa International Tax Affairs Division in advance, no? Para transfer pricing analysis din siya, pero mga critical assumptions lang po yun na doon kasi advance pa siya, wala pang actual na data, no? So, advance, parang sa regular na transactions with the BIR, parang advance ruling. So, this form 1709 is signed under the penalties of perjury. So, sinong magsasign po dito? Signature over printed name of taxpayer, authorized representative, tax agent, indicate title and tax identification number. So, merong tax agent accreditation number or attorney's roll number if applicable, and the date of issue, the date of expiry, no? And then, para may proof na talagang sinabit mo na siya sa BIR, meron siyang stamp of receiving office and date of receipt, no? Kasi wala pang e-filing po itong BIR form number 1709. So, anong gagawin natin dito? Pag nag-file tayo, kailangan may receipt po sa BIR, and that is the proof na nakapag-receive o nakapag-submit po tayo. So, ano po yung ating BIR Form 1709? Ito po yung documentation on related party transactions that we are going to attach when we file our annual income tax return. At yung ating annual income tax return, karamihan po yung deadline dyan is April 15 of the year, of the following year, ha, kung anong taxable year meron ka. But of course, pinakamarami lang yung April 15. There are some corporations na ang kanilang ending is fiscal year, so hindi sila April, no? So iba yung deadline nila, kaya ang deadline din nitong 1709 susunod siya doon sa kung ano man yung deadline ng corporations using the fiscal year, no? So with that, I would like to say thank you and have a good day.